Hey YouTube, Logan with Hideaway Homestead coming to you today with an update on our homestead. We have added Muscovy ducklings. I'm getting the video out late today because I've been working with these little guys. I've been working on our pallet coop for our chickens that are about to hatch. They're going to be hatching tomorrow, and they'll be going in the brooder. And we went to buy some goat milk from a lady, and she happened to have 10 Muscovy ducklings. And since I've wanted Muscovies for a very long time now, against my better judgment, we bought all 10 of them. And here we are, we're gonna have to co-house them with the chickens, which is no big deal at all. They're gonna be in a 12 by 12 structure, so they're gonna have plenty of room. I put them in this little rabbit tractor that I used to have rabbits in, and it worked great because they've got a feeder there, and then I just brought their water here, got me a couple of buckets to where I can wash that out and change it quickly. They tend to dirty it up pretty quick, so but the reason that we're adding the Muscovies to the homestead is, of course, to be able to have duck eggs, but also for meat. Muscovy is compared to baby beef, veal. So I'm really excited about that, about having duck breast and cooking them like steaks, especially considering how high it is to buy steak right now. Hopefully that's going to change, but that's the reason that we're getting the Muscovies here and letting them be part of the homestead, is because they'll give us meat and eggs. And it's a substantial amount of meat. The drakes dress out to be, I think, somewhere around like 10 to 12 pounds. So you're looking at a really large carcass of duck meat. And here we've got June coming here to say hey to the ducks. There she is, getting on to me for speaking English again. So I've got a lid for this because this pallet coop is not enclosed yet completely. So I've got a lid that goes on this and is weighted down where nothing can get into them. They've got slats in the bottom so nothing can dig under. It's going to be really great to be able to take all the drakes and process them for meat. And then the females give anywhere from, I think it's like a 90 to 120 eggs a year. That's in a season. So it'll be really nice to have a lot of eggs and have something that we can treat basically like beef. These are also really great foraging ducks. They will go around, and if you can give them enough space and have enough of a variety of things for them to eat, you can pretty much not feed them. So that's one of the things that really attracts me about the Muscovy ducks, just like the rabbits, is that you can be almost independent from the feed store with, well, or you can be somewhat dependent, almost independent, or completely independent from the feed store. So looking really forward to raising these little guys up, and they're pretty docile. Right now their claws, even though they're little ducklings, are still really sharp, so you've got to be careful with them when you're handling them, especially once they get up big. But they're not as skittish with me as they were. I was sticking my hand in here and like every single one of them would just scatter. But now they're not as, they're still trying to run away, but before I fed them, I took my hand and put feed in it and had them eat out of my hand. So little by little, they'll warm up to us, and they're supposed to be real docile and can get real tame. So that'll be good. The only thing, if you're thinking about getting these, that I guess is kind of a downside to them, is that they can fly, and they can fly like a Canadian goose can fly. So you do have to clip their wings once a year when they go through their molt and their flight feathers come back in. So that's something that you have to keep up with management on them. But I mean, really and truly, a little bit of work one day a year is a fair trade-off for me for all the upsides that there are to keeping these ducks. So we'll be giving y'all updates on them and the chicks. I didn't make any videos when we started incubating the chicks, but since we have them hatch, I'll have a video of them. They are a cross between olive eggers, or well, they're an olive egger rooster and a black Australorp. So there was two of them. There was one rooster and a hen that we got our adult birds from, and then we lost our rooster, and I incubated all the eggs from them. So they're going to be an F2 hybrid. So that means that, you know, it's just second generation. So we'll have them in the videos too with the ducks as once we get everything set up. But if you got any questions about Muscovies, just leave them down in the comments. I'm fairly new to Muscovies. I've done a lot of research on them, and I've we had some when I was growing up, so you know a fair amount of them from just doing all my research and longing to have some for a while. So if you got any questions, I can probably answer anything that's basic. If you have anything to add, or if you've had a lot of experience with Muscovies, leave that down in the comments too. And we'll catch y'all in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe and leave a like on this video. Ring the notification bell if you want to know when I drop new videos. I drop one every day. And thanks for watching.